No, because I've had my birth certificate changed, my social security card changed, my driver's license changed, and there is no other individual under that name existing. So you can climb from here to London, you still won't find that name anywhere.
Join Jackie and me as we hear Sharon Davis tell of her struggle as a female trapped inside a male's body.
My mind's telling me no, but my body's telling me yes, baby.
You are a transsexual, correct?
Yes, that is correct.
Okay, have you ever considered yourself at any point prior to your becoming a woman or your fulfillment as a woman as being a homosexual? Can you make that differentiation for us?
No, because homosexuals are individuals that desire the same sex. Mm-hmm. Whereas though, in my transformation, I've always felt that I was a woman,
okay. Female.
Homosexuals could be male or female, but they want the same sex. Whereas though, if I was content like that, I would have never went through my surgery.
Okay, let's go back to your childhood. At what point did the female in you start coming out?
Approximately when I was about 8 years old, mm-hmm. I began to have different feelings.
What sorts of things did you experience? I mean, both in terms of your own feelings as well as the way people interacted with you.
Well, I knew that I was different from other individuals, other male individuals, that is. I never had the same desires. I've always wanted my own doll. Mm-hmm. I always wanted to be left alone, very neat, very clean, just not rough at all.
I think in your book you refer to, at some point in your childhood, trading in your train or something for a doll. I mean, how real was that experience and what was it like?
Oh, it just made me feel different when I found someone that would make the trade. It's a girl around the corner. She said, sure, I'll trade you my doll. I was like, oh my God, I have a doll of my own, but what am I gonna do with it when I get home, you know?
No, we said in the opening material that you were a woman trapped inside of a man's body. Was that an accurate portrayal for you? Did you honestly feel trapped?
Well, I like to use a statement as to I had to get my body in tune with my mind.
My mind's telling me no.
My mind was always that of a female. I've always felt that way. And therefore, I felt a small correction had to be made. And that, of course, was with the removal of my male organs.
My body's telling me yes.
Let me ask you something that may very well be a philosophical question. As a result of your saying you had to get the body in sync with the mind and
yes,
in the reverse to be true as well, do you feel that in the philosophical sense that perhaps God made a mistake?
Definitely not. I believe that God never makes a mistake. I just feel that, for instance, like some people are born with 6 fingers and 6 toes. God gave the doctors knowledge to remove this extra finger or toe. And I feel the same way in my situation.
Yeah, now, prior to your, as a matter of fact, some time prior to your surgical transformation, you had some hormonal studies done.
Yes.
And what did they show?
That was my chromosome study
okay. That
I had done. Mm-hmm. And it was at a gender identity clinic. It showed that my chromosomes had an imbalance. I had more female chromosomes than I did male. And that's what caused the imbalance, which stated that I should have been born a female.
Was it torturous for you?
Yes.
As a young person?
Most definitely, because individuals didn't understand. And when you don't understand something, you tend to sniggle or laugh or poke, things of this nature. So I've had my trying times.
Did they taunt you?
Occasionally.
How did your family respond to you at the age of 13, 17, whatever? How did they handle your difference?
Well, they were there for me. They never harassed me or anything. It was more or less like a standby and wait and see situation as to what happens. Because you know, when an individual's in their adolescence, they're still growing and it's a possibility that one's mind might change or something of that nature.
Did they hope that you would change?
Well, no, not really. They've always been there for me regardless of my lifestyle and my family, you know. They'll always be there for me.
At what point or age did these feelings begin to manifest themselves in terms of your dress or your actual carriage?
When I was 13.
Actually at 13?
Yeah, I used to go into the gas station bathrooms and go in dressed as a guy, come out, you know, as a female, have my clothes and all. just make me feel, yeah, 13. Mm-hmm.
Why would you go into a gas station bathroom and do that? Why didn't you do it at home?
Because I didn't feel as though my parents were ready for such. Not only that, I don't want to impose what I feel upon anyone. So if I could just go on and live my life and be happy and make everything easy, fine.
Did they know that you were coming out of a gas station bathroom dressed as a female?
No, but they've heard. A lot of people see me and recognize me because a lot of people already say, well, you already look like a girl before the surgery, so.
But we didn't really clarify the difference between a transsexual and a transvestite.
Many individuals tend to get that terminology confused. A transvestite is a male individual that just dresses in female clothing for pleasure, sexual pleasure. Whereas though a transsexual is that individual within heart, mind, body, and soul of that, of the opposite sex, or feeling that they were in the wrong sex, that is. So a lot of people just parade around in women's clothes, and a lot of people think, oh, well, they're gay, or they're homosexual, or they're transsexual, but they're not. They're just wearing these clothes for feeling.
Now, so at the point at which you were going into the gas station bathrooms to change clothes, then you were a transvestite, is that correct?
No, I was always a transsexual. Okay. Always. I've always, because of the fact that I had these feelings about me being a female, that's what changes that. I was never ever content in male clothing.
So that the transsexual doesn't necessarily have to have had an operation to be a transsexual.
That
by
is,
your definition.
That is correct. They are leading up to that. A transsexual is an individual that is in the process of going through hormones and electrologists, if that's necessary, and psychotherapy and psychological and psychiatric treatment leading up to their ultimate goal, which is the surgery.
So at some point in your life, you decided, I have got to make the physical change that puts me in sync with my spiritual self.
That is correct.
When was that?
I think I made that change long ago, but it didn't begin to come into reality until I was about 18.
I noticed you corrected the first caller. She said him.
Yes, that is correct.
So you are no longer a him.
No, well, really, I never was. Just physically there, okay, I was. But I've never been a him, ever. And for someone to say that now, it's more or less like trying to challenge me. You know, and I don't go around parading in the nude trying to show what I have. I am a female. I'm sure there's a lot of men out there that would vouch for me.
Okay, if we did not know that you were once, in name only at least, Roger Davis, and that you're now Sharon Davis, no one would ever know, really, would they?
No, because I've had my birth certificate changed, my Social Security card changed, my driver's license changed, and there is no other individual under that name existing. So you can climb from here to London, you still won't find that name anywhere.
Sharon, I would like to ask you, when you date males for the first time, do you feel a need to tell them that you have had an operation or a sex change?
No, I do not. I don't think that I should have to because of the fact that I'm more or less equal, if not a little bit better, than the next female that they may have been with.
I don't think that I should have to because of the fact that I'm more or less equal, if not a little bit better, than the next female that they may have been with.
Because everything is in working order.
You said there were some criteria you had to meet just to qualify for this kind of surgery. What kind of things were going on?
Well, they have a criteria where it's that you must start on female hormones. And if you have heavy facial hair growth, you have to have that removed by electrologist, which is permanent hair removal. After you go through all that, you need to see a psychologist and a psychiatrist to get an evaluation and make sure you know what you're doing. Because if not, if the doctor just ups and jumps and start doing this operation for people, and then you say, well, I don't want this, then, you know, he's going to be sued for malpractice.
No,
this is a very, very serious situation. It's not just something that you just up and dump, you do it because you want to, and you can pay your money and get it done. It just doesn't work like that. Then you have to cross-dress, meaning cross-dress is opposite. If you're going to change the female, then you dress in that sex for 6 months to a year, which I've did for many years, so that wasn't even a criteria at all for me.